Hi, today we are going to learn a new topic, another method. So in this method we are going to learn a new equation for finding amount in compound interest. Okay, so look at, if P rupees is invested in a scheme giving R percentage interest compounded annually, the amount got after n year is P into 1 plus R by 100 or raised to n. So this is the equation for finding the amount in compound interest. Okay, so the P is amount and then R is rate of interest, then n is number of years. Okay, so using this equation we are going to solve a two questions. Okay, so look at the question in page number 91. So this is the first question. Nancy deposits 15,000 rupees in a bank which pays 9% interest compounded annually. Then how much she get after 2 years? Okay, so our equation is P into 1 plus R by 100 all raised to n. So this is another method for finding amount in compound interest. Okay, so here P is given, P is our amount 15,000, then R is rate of interest, the rate of interest is 9%, then n is number of years, here the number of years 2. Okay, so putting these values in this equation, P into 1 plus R by 100 or raised to n. So here P is 50,000 into 1 plus R is 9 by 100, always n is 2. Okay, so 15,000 into, so 1 plus 9 by 100 means you already learned in 6th standard, 1 into 100 plus 9, which means 109 by 100. Okay, by or raised to 2. Okay, 1 plus 9 by 100 means 1 into 100 plus 9, which means 109 by 100 or raised to 2. Okay, so 15,000 into 109 by 100 means 1 point, when we convert this into decimal we get 1.09 or raised to 2. Okay, 1.09 or raised to 2. So 1.09 means 15,000 into, so find the square of 1.09. So 1.09 over raised to 2 means 1.09 into 1.09. When we multiply 1.09 by 2 times, we get 1.1881. Okay, 1.1881. So multiply 15,000 into 1.1881, we get, which means rupees and 50 paisa, 50 paisa. Okay, so in financial transaction, the amount between 50 paisa and 1 rupees is rounded as 1 rupees, and the amount less than 50 rupees are ignored. Okay, so we just round this as 70,822 rupees. Okay, we just rounded 50 paisa as 1 rupees. Okay, so here once again we just put all the values in this equation. P in 1 plus R by 100 or raised to n, P is 15,000 and R is rate of interest, here the rate of interest is 9%, n is number of years, the number of years is 2, and P 15,000 into 1 plus 9 by 100 over raised to 2, and 15,000 into 1 plus 9 by 100 means 1 into 100 plus 9, which means 109 by 100 over raised to 2, So 15,000 into, when we convert 109 by 100 into decimal, we get 1.09 or raised to 2. And 1.09 or raised to 2 means 1.09 into 1.09, we get 1.1881. And multiply this number by 15,000, we get 70,821.5, which means 70,821 rupees and 50 paisa. And in any transaction, financial transaction, the amount between 50 paisa and 1 rupees is rounded as 1 rupees, and then the amount less than 50 paisa is ignored. So here we just rounded 50 paisa as 1 rupees. So we get 70,822 rupees. Okay, I think understand. Then in page number 92, this is the first question. So look at the first question. So the second question, Anas deposited 20,000 rupees in a bank which pays 6% interest compounded annually. How much should he get back after 3 years? Okay. So here we just first write the details in the question. First P is given, the amount is given, 20,000. Okay. And interest R is given, 6% rate of interest. And the end number of years is also given, 3 years. Okay. So put these values in our equation, P into 1 plus R by 100. Or raised to n, which means 20,000 into 1 plus r by 100 or raised to 3. Okay, so 20,000, 1 plus r by 100 means 1 into 100 plus 1 into 100 plus 6 or raised to 3. Okay, so 1 into 100 means 100 plus 6, 106 by 100 or raised to 3. Okay, so 106 by 100, we just convert 106 by 100 into decimal. So 106 by 100 means 1.06 or raised to 3. So 1.06 or raised to 3 means, so we just multiply 1.06 by 3 times. So we get 1.191016. Okay, and multiply 20,000 into 1.191016, we get 0.32. Okay, here 23,820.32. Here the number after point is the less than 50 paisa. We just ignore this. So we get 23,822 rupees. Okay. Rupees. Okay. So here Anas deposit 20,000 rupees in a bank which pays 6% interest compounded annually. Okay. So how much would he get back after 3 years? So Anas get back after 3 years is, Anas get back, and let's get back after 3 years is 23,820 rupees. Okay, and let's get back after 3 years is 23,820 rupees. Okay, so here the P is given and R is given, N is given. So we just put this all the values in the equation, we get the answer. Okay, so we use P into 1 plus R by 100 or raised any in combo interest only. Okay, so I hope all of you understand. So in this topic we learn the equation for finding the amount in combo interest, which means P into 1 plus R by 100 or raised n. So P is the amount and R is rate of interest and N is number of years. So I hope all of you understand. Thank you.